All right. Okay, I can hear me. All right. Thanks for everyone for coming. Good morning. My name is Matt. I lead the Nervos Foundation, and I'd like to speak to you today about CKB and its place in the blockchain industry. First, I'd like to show my appreciation for all of the miners here today. I have some Bitcoins to give away. Does anyone want these? All right, I got a Bitcoin. All right. Okay. Obviously, these Bitcoins are not real. Anyone who's been in this industry for some time will tell you about the value of knowledge in this industry. One wrong move and you're bankrupt. And this has happened to countless people, regardless of how high they're rolling. I've had the great fortune of spending the last 10 years learning about these systems. I first got interested in Bitcoin for the idea of a system of micropayments that could enable a robust digital economy. I learned about Bitcoin or Ethereum in 2015. It was a late night at a Silicon Valley hacker house, and I remember somebody telling me about how this system could decentralize the functions of governments. And their passion was compelling, but honestly, all I could think about was a generalized blockchain enabling true digital ownership of all the different assets in our world, like books and music and movies and things that used to be physical, but once they went digital, we lost the ability to actually own these things, to resell these things, and to have an economy around them. In 2016, I was fortunate enough to see the early Ethereum community up close in Consensus's office in Brooklyn. I was taken aback by hundreds of people, or about 100 people, working passionately on this groundbreaking technology. I was living in San Francisco at the time, and when I got back, I noticed all the meetups I could find were only about Bitcoin. So I started an Ethereum meetup just before the crazy bull run of 2017. We hosted thousands of attendees in our group and educated developers through an event we call Solidity Saturdays. When it comes to the story of blockchains, I really see it as Bitcoin to Ethereum to CKB. So Bitcoin was different from anything that came before it. Ethereum was also different from anything that came before it. And CKB too is different from anything that came before it. So the reasons why Bitcoin and Ethereum were different are well understood, but the reasons why CKB is are not. So I'll do my best to sum it up quickly. CKB exposes an unprecedented amount of functionality of a blockchain to a developer. And CKB prioritizes flexibility. While most new blockchains we've seen have focused on scaling the throughput of a chain, CKB makes some optimizations, but overall reframes the challenge that blockchains are facing as one of flexibility rather than capacity, and puts faith in the power of abstraction to tackle anything that would come in its way. CKB evolves. It evolves at the smart contract layer, and this allows for changes to be deployed permissionlessly and in a way that won't break the system. So someone may ask, why would a developer want to think about this kind of low-level functionality? For example, the cryptography that their users are using. And the reason why is because technology adapts at an unprecedented pace. And a blockchain is not a good place for adaptation. Blockchains are not fit for constant protocol development. So CKB was built to minimize consensus-level changes and evolve at the smart contract layer. So CKB is truly novel. It's not a fork or an instantiation of an existing framework. It required a new blockchain from the ground up, and work has been going on in earnest for about 6 years now. So my introduction to Nervos was just like anyone else's. There was a question, what is Nervos? And an answer that at the time didn't make a ton of sense. And I'll try this now. So Nervos is a layered network for the future digital economy, and at the heart of it is CKB. I learned about Nervos in the summer of 2018. I was running a co-working space called Starfish Mission in San Francisco. The Nervos team took an office there, and my first What is Nervos conversation did not lead to much understanding, but fortunately for me, I did get the opportunity to learn because the team was looking for some help editing articles. I was strapped for cash because co-working spaces are terrible businesses, and I got the opportunity to learn. This is the first article that I edited, a comparison between UTXO and account model, which doesn't sound like it would be promoting a project. It's a quite jargony title, but to me, this was refreshing. In 2017, I saw hundreds of projects pitch their solutions. I sat in on meetups. I read more white papers than I could count. But what I didn't see was people explaining the foundations of their technology. And what this article gets at was a foundational problem facing Ethereum at the time, and one that Ethereum does not have an answer to yet. And that is the problem of parallel transaction verification. I'll also say that I was never a fan of proof of stake. And even though CKB being secured by proof of work was an odd choice at the time, it did provide me the opportunity to sidestep all of those concerns about Ethereum and proof of stake and to work on a new smart contract platform. And to me, CKB began as a philosophical divergence from smart contract platforms at the time, and it has continued, to this day. The Nervos founders and team were also like the software developers I was used to interacting with when I had a real boring job building accounting systems, and less like the kind of rock star personas that I was seeing in crypto. In those early days, we really were a team of dreamers going against the grain, kind of pursuing this vision that we had for what should be the foundation of these blockchain systems. And while many innovators have pursued a move fast and break things approach, the approach with CKB has been quite different. And I think this cultural difference toward changes is the biggest differentiator between CKB and other smart contract platforms in the industry. CKB targets simplicity at the base layer and then moves complexity upward in the system. This is very much like how a computer works, where it's a very simple machine at its core, but you have complex software that's built on top. Moving away from this idea of move fast and break things, because there's a lot of financial infrastructure in this world that is very old. There are 40-year-old metal boxes in back rooms somewhere that are running critical systems in our world. When we talk about infrastructure, a pursuit of whatever you do, don't break anything, is much better than move fast and break things. And this may be boring for a lot of the kind of projects that we've seen in the industry with the newest DeFi or NFT kind of thing, and taking this approach where the base layer is quite simple does entail a lot of work, but to me, CKB makes a ton of sense. I know that the comprehension of what is exciting about CKB is not very well understood, even in the most technical of circles, and so I'll go through now what I see. So proof of work was a strange choice, I think, when CKB was started in 2018. But ironically, it is one of its greatest strengths. It's orders of magnitude harder to bootstrap a proof of work chain versus proof of stake. And almost all smart contract platforms are secured by proof of stake, so proof of work is a big differentiator for CKB. Also, because proof of work is objective, it can be verified by users. They can connect directly to the network without a need for intermediaries that can censor them and lock them out. Additionally, miners provide a valuable check in the balance of power, and the Nervos community is so much stronger because of miners that have joined its ranks. Additionally, RISC-V. So CKB uses a RISC-V virtual machine, which is a computing standard. It's a chip architecture, and it allows for common programming languages and tools to be used, even open source libraries that are just out there. Recently, Apple and Google announced support for the passkey standard. Just today, Microsoft announced support for this standard, and it allows users to create private keys inside their devices themselves, and these are not like mnemonic words that can be lost or compromised by someone else. The keys always stay within the device. And with CKB, it can adopt this standard easily using off-the-shelf open source libraries. So CKB benefits from the work of an industry and not just a small group of passionate believers. Additionally, quantum resistance has been tested. So CKB can be held through quantum resistant cryptography, and it is out of the reach of tomorrow's quantum computers if users choose to use those wallets. Additionally, any blockchain's wallet can be supported. So Recently, D.ID has been issuing digital IDs to users of any blockchain. CKB also employs a novel architecture. It's hard to explain exactly how it works, but the idea is it's more like Bitcoin and not like Ethereum. And this seems to manifest novel solutions that we haven't seen in smart contract platforms before. An example would be an NFT issuance platform that allows for almost zero cost minting because of these architectural differences. Or the team is pursuing a lightning-like network that should not be encumbered by the limitations of Bitcoin. There's also this unique economic model that gets enabled here, where users can pay miners to store smart contract data. And this economic model ties the adoption of CKB to the native currency and also ensures that miners will always be compensated regardless of transaction demand. One CKB equals one byte of storage on the chain, which also reduces the requirements for full nodes to store the data. Lastly, the Nervos community. So a decentralized thing must be multipolar. It's how you get a balance of power and you get robust decision making through disagreements. And the Nervos community is truly global and multipolar. It has emerged over time. We've had a band of believers that have been that have come together and all believe in CKB, some in the East, some in the West, each with their own community, their own beliefs, and but unique in their own right. I'll say the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones that do, a quote from Steve Jobs. It's been a long path with CKB, but fortunately there have been a number of validation points that we've seen across the industry. First, proof of work. So KPMG and other major players have publicly stated now the societal benefits of proof of work. Ethereum abandoned sharding and now describes itself as a layer one for layer two, very similar to CKB. Account abstraction is a new buzzword, and we're seeing more and more chains hard forking in new cryptography because of user demand. This is exactly what CKB was built for. Even the Bitcoin community is becoming concerned about the size of the blockchain due to the growth of ordinals. Again, something bounding the state is something that CKB was meant to address. We're seeing more and more projects see the benefit of RISC-V. On the subject of light nodes, the largest Ethereum node provider, Infura, has recently announced plans to decentralize, anticipating regulation, while CKB has been designed to always allow users to connect directly to the network. CKB is a long shot. It's a top 200 coin. It always has been, but long shots are okay. I don't see any problem here. Bitcoin was a long shot. The home computer was a long shot. Long shots are the things that can change everything. At the heart of any successful open source project is an idea, a statement, a thesis about the world as it is and how it can be. And in Nervos, I see this. I've been so surprised to see so many people have a similar light bulb moment to me that I had 5 years ago. And I just continue to see more and more people joining this community and jumping on board because of the strength of CKB as an idea. It's a long journey, but as human beings, we're made for these kind of endeavors. I see that CKB is challenging for developers in a way that Ethereum is not. However, teams building in the ecosystem express that things just work, things are well documented, and they're excited about the potential of this platform. The solutions that I see being built on CKB just cannot be built anywhere else. And this gives me confidence that we'll see network effects take place. I'll end by calling back to an experience of WDMS 2019. I remember being a regular guy walking in the door paying cash and frantically walking around trying to find GPU miners to mine CKB and secure the chain for a safe launch. Looking around, I'm humbled by how far our community has come. But also humbled by the size of our ambitions. Satoshi's issuance schedule stretched far beyond that of a human lifetime. And more than any other smart contract platform I can think of, CKB has been designed with this in mind. Today, I have the fortunate role of leading a small group of self-starters, and my role has always afforded me time to keep up with all of the R&D in the industry. With each passing day, I become more and more convinced of CKB's merit and its place in the industry. I want to thank Bitmain for being fans of CKB. I'm enormously grateful for that, and thank everyone for your attention. If any of this has been interesting to you, I suggest checking out the wonderful Nervos community and running CKB. Thank you.